That brings us to the opportunity for citizens to speak. You've got 3 minutes to address the council. Okay, just state your name and.
My name is Chris Nelson. I own property at 8775 County Road 73, Montevallo, Alabama. I wanted to come before the council tonight. I visited earlier in October, but that was before the transition to the new council. And I want to make you guys aware of the proposal that the state is considering to build a public-private partnership prison in Brierfield. I have some information here that I'd like to read through, and then I have some printouts to distribute to you guys. On September 3rd, Governor Kay Abbey revealed that confidential negotiations are in the works with private developers to build a 3,100 inmate prison in Brierfield. It's one of three large prisons the Ivy administration plans to develop to replace most of the state's aging, overcrowded prisons. The others are slated for Elmore and Escambia counties. Ivy is trying a different approach, hiring private developers to finance, build, and maintain the prisons and lease them to the state, a plan that does not require legislative approval. The use of private developers in confidential negotiations has limited public access to information about the project. Residents in Brierfield said they had no warning about what Ivy announced on September 3rd. There was a meeting that was called of the community of Brierfield at the state park there on December 3rd. About 150 residents attended. So they kind of discussed what their issues were with the prison, which are a variety. So let me give you these handouts here before my time runs out.
Proposed prison site in the second page has more information about some articles that are published in local media. The third page has a ad that we're running in local media to kind of make people aware of the prison.
And the last page is a reprint of an article that ran in the Centerville Press that gives a good breakdown of what was discussed at the meeting on September 3rd. I'm making an attempt to visit all of the local cities, towns, and county commissions to make local government aware of what the issues are surrounding the prison and to kind of ask you guys to consider and coordinate with each other to request information from the state. On that second page that I gave you on the back, or actually on the front, it says, what can the city, Montevallo City Council do right now? So these are the things I would think would be in your purview that you could take action on. And I'll just run through those quickly. Number one, Governor Ivey has proposed a 3,100 inmate state prison southwest of Montevallo in Brierfield. The construction, which will affect the nature of traffic flow and density through the city, primarily via highways 25 and 119. Accordingly, any traffic studies, environmental impact statements, public safety concerns, and comments from landowners or residents should be made generally available. Okay, and the city should request these documents be in the public record. Also, since large prison facilities require a substantial amount of potable water, both for drinking and other uses, the city should be notified of any attempt to tap an aquifer or to divert water to the prison. Likewise, with wastewater and sewage treatment, if there's an attempt to tap into municipal sources for that type of service, the city should also be aware of that because it will affect your residents. If the prison is going to provide their own potable water and sewer, then there's also environmental concerns associated with that. So I think you guys want to be aware. And I'd ask that in coordination with the other towns and cities that you guys would approach the state and ask them to release these documents to you and also to coordinate with each other to discuss how this is going to impact you, because it's not an isolated issue. If anyone has any questions, my email address is at the top of that second page. Feel free to reach out to me. And there's lots of resources available online too, if you go to blockthebrierfieldprison.com. But thank you for your time.
And
for
record, as of today, Governor Ivey has not been contacted by any resources from the state or any private firm, so we've had no contact with anybody.
I'd also like to mention Cam Ward has accepted a position to the director of parole and pardons for the state. So if you guys want to reach out to him, hurry before he takes that position, December 7th.